it's been a little while since I've run the chainsaw. It's been crazy hot. I've had a ton of other stuff to do. I got the new Samurai I've been running the small stuff through, but it's one of the coolest mornings we've had in a long time. I've got some big ash logs that I want to get bucked up, so I'm going to go get them bucked up, throw them on the splitter, probably tomorrow or the next day, unless I can get my boys to do it, and have some more ash firewood ready for winter. I threw together another mobile roadside stand. This is going to go at another hot spot right down the road from a KOA campground. A buddy of mine, Jonathan, that makes the maple syrup, it's going to his place, so we'll have another remote location roadside stand out on another high traffic road. Since I ran the chainsaw, I've been used to the Samurai with that measuring stick. I forgot to bring my little stick and my thing of chalk, so I'm gonna grab that, get out there, get some logs marked up, get them picked up with the Ram Splitter 3-point log grapple, and buck them up right next to the splitter. All right, here's just a couple totes, one maple, one poplar. I split these up at night. It was cooler. I was busy all day doing other stuff around the yard, around the house, running errands. So I didn't get this all on video because I was splitting at night, and the camera at night probably isn't that great. Just using an iPhone, so I'm just going to get these moved back into my new storage yard that I'm opening up. And then I'll use a 3-point grapple, bring the ash logs right up here next to the splitter, buck them all up, and they'll all be right here. Getting my process a little better, still got a long ways to go, and eventually I'll be moving it up to my other piece of property. I thought about a few things I can do there to make it even better. There's some huge old arborvitaes that I'll probably take out eventually, get that set up even better.
first few cuts of that were some beautiful bundle grade ash, and the rest will be home heating wood. Ideally, I would be bucking these up on the table side of the splitter or move the splitter. This splitter with that big table on the end is extremely rear end heavy and difficult to move, and taking that table on and off, especially by yourself, is a chore. So for now, I'm just going to buck them up on this side and toss them over to the other, or stack them on this side until I run out of room. Starting to put a plan together for how I want the homewood yard to be set up. I got all my totes over there right now that are full of wood seasoning. That trailer will I plan on using to stock with wood to leave at one of my remote locations. So every time I need to fill it, I'll just have that full of wood. Grab the wheelbarrow, fill it. That way I can drive my little gas mileage car to fill it. This one's a little further away instead of having to take the diesel every time it needs to be filled. Still a lot of cleanup to do. A lot of trees to drop to open up the wood yard so my seasoning area gets more sun. That'll give us more firewood. A lot of logs to buck up, a lot of rounds to split. Hopefully a few more weeks and my new splitter will be done. The part was supposed to have been shipped. He hasn't received it yet though, so I'm keeping my fingers crossed that we have it soon. I'll do some comparisons with Big Blue and the new splitter, and the new splitter versus some other top models that people use that I know who have. Now this log I could run through the Samurai, it's the right size, but I've got the grapple out here. I got the Makita out here, it's throwing good chips today, so I'm gonna cut this log. You guys have seen what the Samurai will do to an ash log about this diameter. We'll see what the Makita does. I already know what's gonna be faster and what I prefer to run. But something about running a chainsaw. It's not crazy hot today. I'm still sweating, but getting out here, getting the saw in my hands feels pretty good again.
Yeah.
Another thing I talked about with the samurai is not needing to mark your logs. I like having a more precise cut, so I mark everything I cut with the chainsaw for the most part. Some stuff I don't, but for the most part I do. I think it looks better. It fits in my stove better. I just think it's a better product all around. Measuring and marking doesn't take a long time, but seconds are minutes, minutes are hours, hours are days. The splitter upgrade is going to be one of my biggest improvements though. All right, this cottonwood here's, or poplar, whatever it is, I got it in a freeload. It's all gonna be campfire wood. Just go in my softwood campfire mix. I mix softwood and hardwoods. It gives you better flame and a long burn time. Throw some birch in there, some cherry, nice smell. When I get cedar, I put a little bit of that in there also, but this log has just been in the way. I can't square this pile up good to shove it all out of the way. So I'm gonna grab a few of these, buck them up, and just kick them to the side for now out of the ash. logs are pretty dirty. I probably should be running the carbide stain on them, but I'm not going to be cutting much longer today, and I'm just going to change the file when I'm done anyway, so. Cottonwood rounds up here into the brush for now, next to the black locust pile my 13-year-old son and 15-year-old nephew split up for me the other day. The slowest splitter in the world. That was a lot of work. Some of those rounds were heavy. My nephew loves working with his hands. I told him for the bigger rounds, just wait and I'll come pick them up and put them on the log table, because I haven't built it into a log lift yet, and I'm not sure I'm going to now with my new splitter coming. But I look over there and he built a ramp similar to Joe with Joe's premium firewood. He did it with a ATV ramp. He took a 2x10 that I had sitting there and built the ramp and was rolling them up, because there was no way those two boys were picking them up. So he thinks outside the box sometimes, knows what it takes to get stuff done. He cleaned the carburetor out on my Honda 250EX, a little sport bike that I let sit too long with regular gas in it instead of rec fuel that I run and everything now. So he got that rebuilt for me, got that thing running great. I'm gonna miss having him around. He's a heck of a worker, but he went back home. I told my brother and my sister-in-law we decided to keep him, but they weren't having it.
Thank you.
Not sure what kind of wood this is. It came from lot one and lot two. I'm thinking maybe elm. Not sure, it'll just go in the mixed hardwood heating wood pile. That's one tank of gas through the Makita. That's all I was gonna run today, but I've got a couple more of these logs I wanna get out of the way. A few more of these cottonwood. I'm sick of moving them, dealing with them. So I'm just gonna get them bucked up and tossed over there for now. I'll go grab the gas and the oil, get her fueled up again, and get a couple more cuts done. All right, we got the Makita gas back up. I'm gonna get a little more cut done, and then I was gonna go install a boom plant for a customer today, but he's not able to do it now, so I think I'm gonna load the tractor up and take it up to my property so I can get working on my boom plants up there. I got some down trees in one of them that I dropped last winter for browse. I gotta get those cleaned up, that'll be firewood, and then I gotta get working on that plot.
Yeah.
some cutting through some dirty wood that Shane took a hit. I think I got one more cottonwood log I'm going to bring over and buck up. Ran about a tank and a half through the Makita, got a bunch of logs ready to get split. Continuing to get the wood yard cleaned up so I can get it reorganized. Get this cottonwood pushed to the side, get the ash split up. And we'll see you guys on the next one. Thanks for watching, hardworking man.